In this video, we will further explore racks in live and take a look at some advanced techniques. You can nest an instrument into an instrument rack, where you can further add instruments to create a layered sound. All we have to do is show the chain list with this button and drag and drop a new instrument into the rack. Alternatively, we can call up the context menu and choose Create Chain. We can then drag and drop a new instrument into our empty chain. You can map more than one parameter to any macro control. First, I'm going to show my macro controls and then click on the Map button. I'm going to click on the filter frequency to select it and then click the Map button underneath Macro 1. You can also map via the context menu. I'm going to right-click on the time parameter and also map that to Macro 1. If I show the browser section of Live's interface and engage the Map button again, I can see the mapping browser. Here I can set the ranges of my mapped parameters. In this example, I would like the filter movement to be less extreme, so I'm going to set its range to begin at 300 Hz and end at 2000 Hz. You can also invert the minimum and maximum values via the context menu. In this next example, I have an instrument rack containing three different instruments. When I play notes on my MIDI controller, I would like the lower register to play a bass sound, the middle register to play a piano instrument, and the upper register to play a bell sound. The key button unfolds the key zone editor, allowing me to define a key range for each chain in my rack using zones. I can choose which keys are sent to which chain by dragging the sides of my zones, and I can fade in and out of my zones by dragging the small upper handle. The VEL button, or Velocity Zone Editor, is similar. I can assign chains to different ranges of note velocity using zones, which I can either step or fade between. In this example, I will add a noise sample loaded into a sampler. Let's set up this rack so that I only hear the noise sample if I play notes with a velocity value of 100 or more. Clicking on the Chain button opens the Chain Select editor. Let's add a fourth instrument to this rack and use the Chain Selector to fade between our original three sounds and the new one. Once again, I can resize the zones by dragging their sides, and I can fade between them using the upper handles. At the top, we can see the Chain Selector ruler, which allows us to switch between zones. I can manually move this icon around, or I can map it to a macro control. We can increase or decrease the size of the zone, velocity, and chain editor interfaces by calling up the context menu and choosing between small, medium, and large. Once I have finished setting up my rack, I can click the Hide button to save on screen space. So far, we have been working with an instrument rack. The same three options can be found in MIDI effect racks, whereas audio effect racks simply include a chain editor. This is a great way to crossfade between two very different chains of audio effects. You can nest a rack within a rack, creating endless possibilities for sound and instrument design. In this example, I have nested an instrument rack inside another instrument rack. This allows me to use MIDI effects like scale before the instruments, and audio effects like this hybrid reverb after the instruments. The great thing about this workflow is that I can now manipulate MIDI effect parameters, instrument parameters, and audio effect parameters from the same interface of 16 macro controls. If you take a rack and put it inside another rack as I have done, you don't lose your mappings. Simply map the original macro controls to the macro controls on your new rack. Finally, we can rename and recolor the macro controls by calling up the context menu.